I'm going to quickly demonstrate how to use stretch that note drum elements. The element series differs from the drum series in that there are individual types of sounds for each module. So this particular range of the elements modules concentrates on claps. There are 7 modules in all. One is free for you to download so you can test and experiment and see if you like the product. What I've done is span 60 clap samples across a keyboard template and created very specific effects and dynamics for that particular type of sound. So if you were to get the kicks element series or the snares element series, although the format would look the same, some of the effects and dynamics would be different. Best way to do this really is just to hit play. I've got a very simple sequence going here. The kick drums that you hear are taken from DruMM, the series itself. As with all of my modules, there are envelopes for filters and amplitude. So I'm going to leave that alone for now. Pretty self-explanatory. If not, download the manual. All the details are in there. So let's start this off with a nice sequence. Now I'll just randomly play around. So this is a transient control, which controls the actual overall shape of the whole sound. The best way to explain this really is just to play with it. This adds subharmonic presence to the sample. Great if you're using it with things like the dirt and the crush. Air is presence, so it's high pass, reverb, and so on and so on. You can have all out reverb, or you can just have it for a little bit of presence. Funk is a feature I put in there that plays like a ghost note or an immediate delay, but you do have control over the timing. They are fixed into divisions and you give it a rate. So we'll start with that. Let's change the rate. You can hear that ghost note that follows it. You can give whatever amount of that you want. The divisions are put here so that it syncs up to your BPM. And bloat just makes things bigger. Great on specific types of clap sounds. We'll try it on this. It just makes it all very much, well, bigger really. Let's crush it. Give it that nice little crumbly effect. These two, squeeze A and squeeze B, are sort of inversely proportional EQs. Best way to explain that is look at the diagrams in the manual, but basically what happens is as you move the bandwidth or the width of the bandwidth, you're changing gain values and frequency values. Again, best way, play with it. They work across different frequency ranges and very specific ones, so you can use the two together without getting phasing. Standard filter. great fun. One last feature I'd like to show you is MIDI select here. If you switch this on, whatever note you hit, and I'll play it so you can see the clap that shows up. That's the note we're editing. You can select from a drop-down menu, or you can just press MIDI and change the sounds on the fly. It's completely up to you. There you go. Very versatile, very cheap, and hopefully very useful. Thanks again for your time. I'd love it if you created some manic beats and sent them in to me. I'd love to know how drum is being used. All the drum modules. That's Epic, Drum, Elements, etc. If you don't have Kontakt, the samples are also available separately. And they're again on the stretchthatnote.com site. Thanks again.